Welcome students. So in the previous video we tried to understand what is a ballad and the explanation of the poem of the 16 stanzas. Whatever 16 stanzas we have here, we tried to understand the meaning of each stanza. So this poem, you all would agree, is a criticism of the selfish and self-serving attitude of people who dismiss the weak and needy. They are so consumed in their greed that they rather ridicule the needy than help them. So this story in Northland, the poetess has she begins by describing the place called Northland as cold and dry. The wintry nights, they are so taxing that usually people spend them awake, unable to find warmth. The people do enjoy the snow through playing and tending to the animals. And often the kids are covered in clothes that are heavier than body weight, making them appear as small bears. So the poet introduces a popular legend on Northland. The legend might be unreal, but it still carries an important moral lesson. So she begins to narrate it. The legend speaks of Saint Paul, who traveled far and wide to preach his version of religion. On his way, on one of his journeys, he suffers from pangs of hunger and decides to ask a good woman to feed him like a noble Christian. The woman is a she's a baker, and she decides to honor his request. The greedy woman, she decides to bake the cake for him, but selfishness clouds her good intentions, and then she thinks that her bread is too big and thick to be wasted on as a charity, and she decides to bake another smaller one. And then unfortunately her greed is more powerful than her good judgment, and every time the bread is almost finished, she would prepare another one, even smaller. In the end, she cannot even find enough compassion to part with the smallest piece of bread. So with this, the saint is enraged. The drama enrages the saint, who loses his patience with the woman, and he put a spell on her that turns her into a bird. He commands her that she take all the comforts she enjoyed as a human for granted and would now have to work for everything as a bird. So the poetess now remembers that people can still see that bird searching for food in Northland. She believes that the bird and the legend serve as a reminder of her greed, and to stay clear of such toxic beliefs of self-service when there are people who suffer from absolute scarcity and deprivation. So our wealth and luxuries should not hold us back from helping others in need. So she advises us to learn and apply the lesson of kindness in our lives. So even though selfish people may never transform into birds, they may have a far worse, and you can say they may become cold-hearted humans, which is not the right thing. So the theme, as I've already told you, so the greedy woman is condemned to hard labor for food and shelter like a bird. So it's a narrative by the poetess and a direct criticism of negative traits of human behavior. How it can make us, the greediness can make us shallow and self-centered. Now coming to the literary devices in the poem, you probably would have noticed that there is a lot of repetition we find in the poem. You all will agree? There is repetition, like away, any, rolled and rolled, boring and boring. Then you find alliteration here. still smaller, faint, fasting. Then the hearth, woman was, telltale. So there are many instances of alliteration. You will also find simile. Yeah, you will find. See, like the children look like bears, cubs. Then another one is baked thin as a wafer, or clothes were burnt black as a coal. So these are all examples of similes. Also, you will find that there is enjambment, running lines of poetry from one to the next without using any kind of punctuation to indicate a stop. So you can find in stanza 1, line 3 and 4. Then in stanza 2, line 1 and 2. Even line 3 and 4. So like that you can find out where do you find come across enjambment. Now this is for us is the time for finding the answers to the reader's exercises. You will have to find out the answers, and also children, very important one is to paraphrase the whole poem, The Legend of Northland, in about 10 sentences. So there are 16 stanzas, so be a little wise, try to, you know, merge two or three stanzas into one sentence, that so that you come up with 10 sentences and you without distorting or, you know, missing out any important line of the poem. So from me this much. I hope it's clearer for you. Okay, bye children, all of you.